To reach the SDG zero hunger, we must remember that while we produce enough food globally, we don't produce enough food where people need food too often. Too often the food that is produced in sub-Saharan Africa, Southeast Asia, and Latin America is not enough to support the nutritional needs of the population in those locations. The challenges that we have today are access to available, affordable, nutritious food for everyone, everywhere. And that nutrition is quite important, ensuring that it's not just calories, but nutrient-rich calories. The challenge of micronutrient deficiencies continues to increase. Overweight and obesity are increasing not just in the developed world, but in the developing world as well. Because what we see is that as populations increase their economic opportunity, that they also adopt a Western diet, the worst of our diet, salt, sugar, fat. And as a result, in too many countries, we are now seeing an increase in what we call the double burden of malnutrition. Those who suffer from undernutrition, not receiving enough kilocalories, and those who suffer from overweight and obesity, eating too many of the foods that are calorie dense, but nutrient poor. And so what we require is that we must, as a global community, understand what is the diet that is necessary to support the nutritional outcomes that are required for a healthy body wherever you live. And that will require collective action by all parties, including governments as well as private sector. There is a role for philanthropy as well as for business in changing our global food system. In order to ensure that those who do not have the financial resources to support the access to nutritious food that is required, we must have the humanitarian responses that are necessary to ensure that that food can be provided. Whether it's in the developed world where we support charities and community organizations that ensure no person goes hungry, or it's in the developing world where we ensure that the NGOs, civil society, and governments have access to the capital that is necessary so that those who cannot feed themselves, who do not have access to enough of the financial support that is necessary for them to meet their nutritional needs, that they can access the food that is required. But on the other hand, we must ensure that there is more investment capital that supports the increase in market-based businesses that can create the sustainable, durable food systems that will allow for economic opportunity as well as for the access to affordable, nutritious foods by those around the world. We need to make a change. We need to ensure that business investments, business actions are aligned and supporting those who live in developing countries, as well as those who live in developed countries who are in lower income communities. That means changing our ideas about risk. There are markets in low-income communities that some economists suggest are in excess of $250 trillion if we are willing as business leaders to make those investments that catalyze the activities that change business opportunities that provide for more support for lower income communities that are too often ignored. And it's a win-win then. It's a win for the business that invests. It is a win for the communities that increase their economic opportunity. And it is a win for all of those who need access to affordable, nutritious food.